During the gathering, the founder of the Girl Power Ministries said no one is useless in the world and that there is no exercise better for the heart than reaching down and lifting people through giving and helping.
My cry to the people is that we cannot be in the same land that people are starving, you know, people are walking around naked. It is a disgrace to we who feel that we are the affluent in society. You are never rich until you can make others rich. You are never blessed until you can bless others. You are never visited until you can be a visitation to others. And that is what God said to Abraham. He said, I'm making you a blessing so that you can bless other nations. So for those of you that are blessed, who feel you are affluent, join the cry to Karamoja. Bless these people.
Stephen Shaka, a resident of Entebbe, urged Ugandans to engage in government programs that are aimed at uplifting the community, such as the Parish Development Model and Emyoga, among others.
Encouraging the communities to love one another, to give, to support the various activities. Already our government is giving through the Parish Development Model to support the various businesses. That is part of what we are talking about. Giving to the community and supporting them.
Meanwhile, Bunyoro Kitara Diocese has joined all students of Naigana Government Aided Secondary School in Kagadi District to restore its glory following its dilapidated school structures. Speaking as a guest speaker during the fourth All Students Reunion celebrations at Naigana Secondary School today, Noalin Basemera Kisembo, the Chibale District Woman MP and an old student of the school, asked government to fund the school as well as putting the many teachers in the school on government payroll.
Help such schools, especially this particular one, Naigana Secondary School, that we can have more teachers enrolled and if possible, those who are already teaching in this school and are being supported by the parents, if they can be put on payroll, it will be even more helpful. Because we have also experienced some.
Leaders have lobbied the government to take part in revamping Naigana Secondary School. The Bishop of Bunyoro Kitara Diocese, Right Reverend Samuel Kahuma, who was represented by the Diocesan Secretary for Education, Jotham Biaruhanga, as a chief guest, noted that the diocese has embarked on restoring the glory of the school.
In Hagati, Yentekan Zazaitas of Bunyoro Kitara, Omukurakuran, Tikisovoka Kubo Muntu Kugamba, Nguito of our foundation, Nguito to be our mire.
To the construction, the school has other challenges. For instance, we have only 13 teachers on government payroll, and we have other 15 teachers who are not on government payroll, who are paid locally by the parents, and we get problems in payment of salaries to these teachers and other non-members of the non-teaching staff, who are about 13, who are also paid by parents.
Even if we still get that same school truck, can be doing other things. Because these days, I understand, we have got modern ways of transporting our students and other people. It is not bad even the government to give us a bus, because we are one of the fighters. The government, which is now in power, got a school truck from here in 1981, and it helped it so much. Now we still, we are guarding ourselves as fighters, so we are requesting for the government to give us a moderate means of transport so that our students can have some excursions, can go out on tour.
The school head girl, Lilian Alituha, applauded all students and leaders for fundraising for the construction of the girls' dormitory.
Glad. And you know, as a girl student, of course, we need some kind of security for our better personal hygiene, because there are very many various diseases that can transmit through bathrooms, lack of enough bedding. But since they are going to construct us new dormitories, I have a hope that all these diseases, for example, the candida, the syphilis, that can easily be transmitted, are going to be capped.
Over 10 million shillings was raised in cash and pledges in a bid to construct the girls' dormitory, which will cover over 200 million shillings. Report by Godfrey Sempija and Andrew Musengozi for the news.